Well, good morning to everybody, and welcome to all of the new faces behind the new masks in our assembly here today. Welcome, just to review some of the things that we have been doing, so you can feel at home, is that we're observing 6-foot distancing marked by the blue crosses on the pews. If you are of a single person, sit on a blue cross. If a household, then you can kind of sit around that blue cross, but it helps to distinguish the safe distancing that we need to observe. And we also ask that you wear masks or some kind of face covering over both your nose and your mouth throughout the duration of the liturgy. And finally, we will speak all of the responses for Mass. And Sherry will sing, in an exercise of a priesthood of the laity, some hymns for all of us during the course of the liturgy. And so we now begin with our opening hymn. Please stand as Sherry will sing for us to God our opening hymn. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. I'd like to extend a welcome to all of us who have physically gathered in our assembly, but also those who God are gathering with us this morning, who are tuning in on our YouTube channel or Facebook Live, or who may be watching it a little later in a recorded version. Welcome to all of you as we join together under God's gathering power in prayer and in sacrifice. Paul says at the beginning of his second letter to the Corinthians, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and God of all encouragement, who encourages us in every affliction, so that we may be able to encourage those who are in any affliction with the encouragement with which we ourselves are encouraged by God." Certainly, disciples of Jesus are always afflicted, as the world is afflicted. But we have the encouragement of God to persevere and to share that hope with others who are likewise afflicted. This is the role of the disciple. This is the role of all of the saints that we remember on this weekend. And so as we continue to gather in God's gathering power, we call to mind the ways that we may have been infected by the affliction of sin in our lives, and turn to God in God's healing, compassion, and mercy for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And having acknowledged now and received God's forgiveness, we continue our gathering by offering our praises to God by saying together, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And so, as we complete our gathering, let us collect all our prayers into this one prayer. Let us pray. O Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you for which we earnestly long. We pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. After God gathers, God feeds. And so God feeds us at two tables. The first table is here at the table of God's word. And so let us be nourished by a few tasty morsels. The first from a reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels, who were given power to damage the land and the sea. He said to them, "Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God." I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. Now, after this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our Father, be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? One whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet, so we are. The reason that the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure, as he is pure. The word of the Lord. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. And blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. And blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. You know, in the month of November, our nation always observes a Veterans Day. It's a day where we remember and honor all of the men and women who either they themselves or their mothers and fathers came from another country and settled here, and having become citizens here in this country, have offered their lives to the service of our country in the defense of our freedom, in the defense of our Constitution, and in the hopes of establishing a peace, a worldly peace, but peace nonetheless. And we also remember not just those who have come back from the wars and who have served in the military, even in peacetime, but also those who have given their lives. Oftentimes we remember veterans by name. Oftentimes we have ceremonies to honor them, and many gather together in these celebrations. I would like to propose to you that today, All Saints Day, is a Catholic version of Veterans Day. And today, Catholics around the world remember all of those veterans who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, to work to promote to proclaim God's presence in their time and in their place, to establish the weight of God's glory in the midst of the weight of whatever affliction that they their time endured, and that they are veterans of holiness, these disciples, these saints. They are veterans who come from every nation, every race, every people, every tongue. And they, with their lives and their examples, provide example for us, who one day will be veterans of holiness as well, but may need their encouragement, their prayers, their hope, so that we might be able to live in the afflictions in our time and in our place, to celebrate God's graces in spite of these afflictions, and to share that hope with others. All of us, here and now, are on the front lines of holiness, engaging the powers of evil as Jesus engaged the powers of evil, and as Jesus died and rose and began to vanquish the powers of evil, the power of sin, out of creation, to restore you and me and all of creation to the original blessing that God has intended, that we participate in this engagement on the front line in the ordinary works of our everyday lives. And as we are engaged in this, sometimes we grow tired. Sometimes the afflictions become too much for us. Yet there is always the hope in God. The letter to the Hebrews is an example of such encouragement for us on All Saints Day. It is a message of encouragement to Christians in the writer's time who have grown weary and indifferent to their Christian faith. The letter rouses them to a new ardor of holiness. He mentions the veterans of holiness in the Old Testament, like Abraham and Moses and Gideon and Samson and David and the prophets, but also spends a lot of time on Jesus, the Son of God, the high priest, who in his own life had taken on all the afflictions from the powers of sin onto his own body, and sacrificed it to God, thus destroying the power of sin and giving all of us new life, new hope. And all who follow are called or challenged to be awakened to this life and continue to follow Jesus as disciples in this engagement in restoring the original blessing God has intended for all of us in all of creation. All of us have different gifts. All of us are afflicted in different ways. All of us have certain weaknesses, but all of it coming together under the grace of God can make a stand against sin. Even when we are tired, even when we are afflicted, in fact, especially when we are tired, especially when we are afflicted, can God's grace be made known to us and can lift us up, and not only lift us up, but others in our lives with whom we have great influence. Now, I could list a lot of saints in the official canon of the saints and look to their examples, but I'm going to mention just one example today, someone who's not on the canon, but someone who had a struggle in their faith and who has been able to share their struggle with us, and who I would say is a saint, is a veteran of holiness that we can look to. Her name is Flannery O'Connor. Many of her short stories are inspiring a younger generation today, for within her short stories are imbued the struggle of her faith, the struggle of faith, and the hope of overcoming the afflictions in our lives. I read her spiritual journal that she kept when she was a college student, still blossoming, still wondering about her gifts, still finding focus, still asking in hopes of God to deliver her. The first entry reads as a prayer: please let Christian principles permeate my writing, and please let there be enough of my writing published for Christian principles to permeate. I dread, O Lord, losing my faith. My mind is not strong. It is a prey to all sorts of intellectual quackery. Here, Flannery knows what God is calling her to do and prays for God to help her in what she, to express God's grace in her talent. But also she expresses her struggles, her times of being afflicted, her times of growing tired, and asking God to deliver her from all sorts of evil. And this second entry, she writes in a way of like confirming her faith: I must write down that I want to be an artist, not in the sense of aesthetic frippery, but in the sense of aesthetic craftsmanship. Aren't all veterans of holiness, aren't all veterans of disciples, craftsmen and women in one way or another, for always intentionally and conscientiously incorporating the presence of God that they are aware of in their life in all that they do? And it is indeed not easy. She goes on, all of our lives are consumed in possessing struggle, but only when the struggle is cherished and directed to a final consummation outside of this life is it of any value. I want to be the artist I want to be the best artist as possible for me to be under God, acknowledging the struggles, yet acknowledging the commitment of her faith to glorify God. for she knew that she was a child of God, and what she has yet to be has not yet been made known to her, but she was confident of the hope of victory, that she would come to see God's face in her lives. So it is for all the veterans of holiness, for all of the saints, and for you and for me, that with the promise of victory, of the complete vanquishing of all sin out of God's creation, that we are encouraged in our struggles, encouraged in our afflictions. So who are these wearing white robes, and where do they come from? They are you and me. They come from the ordinary lives that we live, where we come to put faith in the promise and graces of God to transform us in our afflictions, in our poorness, in our mourning, in our meekness, in our hunger and thirst for righteousness, in our need of mercy, in our clean heart, our being peacemakers, in our being persecuted or insulted for the sake of Jesus. That in all of this, there is hope, there is promise that we will endure in the struggles, in the affliction, to the point of even helping others in their struggles and afflictions as well. These are the veterans of holiness, the veterans of discipleship, the saints of God, continually gathered by God and continually sent to serve the world. Together, let us now profess our faith in the words so many saints before us have done. I believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We are God's children now, and we shall see him as he is. In the hope that is strong amidst our affliction, we offer these prayers in purity of heart. For all of those who have been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic, especially those who are sick, those who have become unemployed, those who suffer from anxiety or addiction, or may be afflicted with grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for all of those involved in relief of this pandemic, the healers, the doctors and nurses, the researchers for treatments and vaccinations, the civil and religious leaders making difficult decisions, and the essential workers. We pray to the Lord. For all living saints in every nation, that they may work to manifest God's kingdom here on earth, we pray to the Lord. For family members and mentors and coaches and teachers and others who have inspired us by their faith, that we may find favor with God by growing in that inspiration to endure during affliction and offering hope to others, we pray to the Lord. For the protection of those serving our country, for world peace, for an end to racism, for economic justice, for care for creation, and for the dignity of human life from the womb to the tomb, we pray to the Lord. For our parish missions, Caring for Bethlehem, Community Services Council of Woodbury, Carolyn's Place, St. Vincent de Paul Soup Kitchen, and for Niños de la Luz in Honduras, we pray to the Lord. For all who have died, that they may enjoy the fullness of eternal happiness in the presence of all the saints, especially for Dr. Virginia Perkinson, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. And for the intentions written in our two books of hope, the intentions recorded on our parish prayer line, and for the intentions we know and hold in the silence of our hearts. United with our universal prayer, we pray to the Lord. Lord God, in the communion of your saints, look kindly upon the people who long to see your face, and grant these petitions through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
from the table of the Word to the table of Christ's body, God continues to feed us. And having set the table and prepared the gifts, pray, my sisters and brothers, that these, your sacrifices and mine, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his church. O Lord, may these sufferings we bring in the honor of all this, may these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This preface describes how the communion of saints, the veterans of holiness, engage us in our present time and encourage us on to a glorious future. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our Mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Eucharistic prayer expresses what all saints know, all disciples of Jesus, of the working of God in our lives and in all creation, the sacrifice of love that Jesus has showed to us, and the implications in our lives that make our life, that transform our lives. O Lord, you are holy indeed, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Holy Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and we profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. And may he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and in charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Archbishop, Juan Miguel, our auxiliary, with all the clergy, all the religious, all the laity, and the entire people you have gained for your own. And listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For it is through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught all the saints how to pray, and they indeed pray. And so we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
So let us turn to the cameras and offer those watching a sign of peace, and offer a sign of peace to all of us gathered here. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him, Jesus, the Prince of Peace, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To review how we receive communion, we receive communion section by section, beginning with the St. Teresa of Avila section, and then followed by the Holy Family section. Each section at the appropriate time will come down the middle aisle, observing the social distancing that is marked on the floor. And when one comes to the cross at the front, one, please stop. And from there, I will present to you the body of Christ. And you will say from there, amen. And then you'll come forward with your hands extended. And I will then place the Blessed Sacrament in your hand. And the St. Teresa side will go before the St. Teresa statue. And there one can remove their mask, consume the Blessed Sacrament, replace their mask, and return to their pew along the side aisle. And in a similar way, as the Eucharistic prayer says, the people on the Holy Family side will go before the Holy Family statue, where they can receive the Blessed Sacrament, replace their mask, and return toward the side aisle on that side.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, as we adore you, who alone are holy and wonderfully in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness and the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
November is also the month of happy remembrance of all the faithful departed who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith. If you would like, you could send in names written legibly, either by email or on the All Souls Day envelope, and we will put them in a book of remembrance. And that book of remembrance will be updated throughout the month of November, and it will definitely be posted on our parish website so that we all can safely read the names and pray for the names. I will pray for the names every single day at Mass and in our personal prayer, my personal prayer. And if I find a safe way to display them in the sanctuary, I'll do that as well as I have done in the past. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go and spread the gospel of the Lord.
Amen.